Hi, this is Sheshanan from Aerotech Solutions. I just want to give lecture on RAM memory organization from 8051 microcontroller. So the name RAM defined as random access memory. So this memory allows to store data temporarily, and this allows both read operations and as well as write operations from 8051 controller. So as a quantity from 8051, which is 128 bytes, so that addresses from 0 to 127, the same which is represented in hexadecimal format as 00H to 7FH. And this memory is data memory from microcontroller families. So even in embedded C programming, you can use the standard keyword as data before data type. So this is your locations representation. So each location allows 1 byte of data. That is, your decimal representation is 0 to 255 and hexadecimal representation is 00H to FFH. And the initial address of RAM memory anyway starts from 00H, and 7FH is the hexadecimal representation of RAM memory address locations. So again, this memory, which is distributed into different sections as banks and bit addressable space and scratchpad memory. So these 128 locations, which are divided into 3 individual sections. Whereas banks are 32 locations and bit addressable space is 16 locations, and scratchpad memory is remaining 80 locations out of 128. So 32 locations for banks, so that the addresses calculation should be 00H to 1FH. This is your hexadecimal representation of addresses, otherwise in decimal 0 to 31. Whereas 16 locations of bit addressable, so anyway after 1F 20H is the address from hexadecimal, and the ending address is 2FH, so that 16 locations of bit addressable space. And from 30H to 7FH scratchpad memory. So these are 3 individual sections from 128 bytes of RAM memory. See the individual sections again, banks. There are 4 banks from 8051, which are bank 0, bank 1, bank 2, bank 3. So you already noted the registers which are indirectly, which are used RAM memory locations to store their data. There are the list of SFR registers and general purpose registers from 8051. The general purpose registers, which are going to use banks from RAM memory. There are 4 individual banks and each bank 8 locations. So that addresses 00H to 07H. Bank 1 addresses are 08 to 0FH. Bank 2 addresses are 10H to 17H, and bank 3 addresses are 18H to 1FH. And these registers, they can use any bank from 4 individual banks, but depends on register selection bits from PSW register, which decides the bank which are used by registers defined by RS0 and RS1 logics. If RS1, RS0 logics are zeros, the registers uses bank 0. If these 2 bits are 01, registers uses bank 1 memory locations to store their data. If RS1 or RS0 as 10, registers uses bank 2 memory locations, and 11, bank 3 memory locations. Finally, the registers uses 1 complete bank to store their data. The remaining locations, even there is a hidden section which is stack from 8051. Always stack deals with two standard instructions, push and pop. Push allows to move the content to stack memory, and pop instruction allows to get the data from stack memory. And stack pointer default holding address is 07H. Once you started using push instruction, then it increments one address automatically, so that storage starts from 08. By default, registers R0 to R7 uses bank zero memory locations, so that the stack memory, which allows to store data from 08. If you are using individually these locations, you can need to handle with the addresses. But once you start using push instructions in your programming, then it allows to store in a sequential order, starts from 08, 09, 0A, it continues. And every stack memory follows two different formulas, depends on devices. So there are two standard formulas about stack memory: FIFO, first in, first out, and LIFO, last in, first out. 8051 controller follows LIFO rule from stack memory, so that whatever the last data which is into stack, which comes out first. So that's about your stack section from 8051 RAM memory. The next section is bit addressable space. There are 16 locations of bit addressable space from 20H to 2FH. And the meaning of bit addressable is very clear. Each location is divided into 8 individual bit locations, so that if your source content is single bit, then you can use this bit locations to store your single bit binary data. Based on the source content, the microcontroller automatically allows to store your information in these bit locations. If there is a 1 byte value, it allows complete location. It always depends on the source content from your instruction. If the source content is single bit, like carry flags or any single binary bit, so you can use this bit addressable locations from RAM memory. So each location is divided into 8 individual bits, and these bits have their own addresses. So generally, if you are writing the instruction move 00H, comma 1 byte constant value followed by hash, which is 25H, so it allows to give the complete location. Suppose the single bit content, if I am writing move 00H, comma C, so generally carry is a single bit, so which allows to save in 20H 1 byte location, and where again this location 00H bit address, which always checks whether the source content is single bit or 1 byte, more than single bit. If it is a single bit, it allows to store into this bit addressable locations. If more than 1 bit, it allows to prefer complete location. The advantage with this bit addressable space is very clear. It allows to store single bits followed by their addresses, or else if you want to use one complete location, you can access with the address. And the next section of RAM memory is scratchpad memory. So this memory has only option you need to handle with the addresses. So again, the addresses starts from 30H, after 2FH there is a 30H, and ends with 7F, and these locations allows to save 1 byte data. And this is the complete RAM memory organization of 128 bytes. For more videos, just follow our channel Eratech Solutions. Please like, share, comment. And if you are looking for online training or classroom training, you can visit our address or you can contact us. So this is my mobile number, 9676327118, or you can email us any queries on this RAM memory organization. Thanks for watching.